Hello you beautiful legends and welcome to this second take, because the first one was disrupted by someone wanting information about sauna. It's an episode number 666. Some more superstitious people, or you know, religious people, would say that it's an evil number. It's not, it's just a number. But it's 666 days since this project started. And by project, I mean there is a blog and there is podcast. This is the podcast that you're listening or watching at the moment. As you can see, I'm in the car at the moment, just wrapping up after evening deployment of sauna. So for those of you that are new to the channel, we recently, myself and my wife and my son, basically, we started a small business based on mobile sauna. So basically we have what you see in the background, that wooden parts, is a barrel sauna that is bolted to the trailer. And what I do is basically I drive onto the beach, like this one in Rosnola, Ireland, and basically serve customers. So whoever wants to use sauna within the hours that we come here, they can pay for a session, 30 or 60 minutes, and they can go in and out to the ocean within that time period, however or how many times they want. And basically that's it. That's the business. I deployed it today, so I'm alone. Usually I do it with my wife and Julian sometimes, but today I came alone and basically operated sauna myself. We had a pre-booked session for 5 people. Then it was pretty quiet, and later on I got another 4 people, so one single person and a group of 3. So not bad for the evening, but it can be better. We are just, you know, getting momentum now. We started barely 5 or 6 weeks ago, so it's picking up on social media and in the neighborhood. So people starting to know about it and spread the word, and that's visible. People are coming and saying that they heard about sauna or they saw the sauna. So it's good. I usually do the updates about a particular day, but yesterday I did update about Saturday. So a bit of a backlog, and I think that works better if I do journaling, but recording on the day what happened the day before. So I already said too much about today, I guess. But yesterday, Sunday, was pretty interesting, because we not only deployed the sauna in the morning and we got a good amount of bookings beforehand. So we operated from about 9 o'clock until 2 p.m. And by us I mean I operated, because Elizabeth and Julian stayed at home. We were planning on going in the evening, but eventually we just did morning session and then decided to skip the evening, because we wanted to see together the Euro 2024 soccer final. And even that didn't happen as expected, because we decided to go for a ride and do some walk or hike. And we did a hike close to Inch Island, where we actually went into Inch Island and back. We looped around the bird sanctuary there. It was very nice. Especially the first part. The second part was a little bit boring, but we found a nest with 2 small birds still blind and waiting for mother or father, I suppose, to bring them food. Then we saw a lot of different birds in the area. And afterwards we had a booking, a table in the railway tavern, which we were before. And they had amazing steak on the grill and amazing burgers. And we went there together to get a proper nice evening out and eat there. And while we were there, we were kind of half watching the match on the phone. So we got the best of both worlds, I guess. And that was pretty much yesterday. Nothing else much happened, so that's pretty much the updates for today. Apologies for being a bit here and there, but I want to go back home. I'm really tired after yesterday and the day before and today. So I need to get proper sleep and resync with some natural and nice routine or rhythm of waking up and doing stuff. There's a lot happening behind the scenes, but I will be talking about it once everything settles, and I can't talk about it because there are legal implications to that thing. Don't worry, it's not a crime or anything like that, but there is legality behind it that I need to keep my mouth shut. There's a lot of screaming. I'm not sure if you can hear it, but there's a group of people with kids as well that are pretending to be some hardcore rugby players or whatever, that they make screams during their play. I guess they are having fun. I had fun as well. I went to the ocean and then heated up myself in a sauna. I'm ready to go. Oh, almost ready. Good that I didn't forget. I need to strap the window or the door from the stove, because I might lose it on the way. That's actually a good reminder. Otherwise, I would be already driving and who knows what would happen. Beautiful sunset. Well, kind of. You can probably see it a bit. Not sure how much you can see. My wife is ringing, so let me wrap up. Thank you very much for tuning in. Have a great rest of the day, afternoon or evening. Stay tuned and see you again tomorrow.